A lot of Israelis, if they have musical pursuits, go to New York or they go to London because they don't think that they can start their career. Their career can't happen in Israel. But you chose to stay in Israel. What made you decide to stay in Israel?
Well, I did the Yamonite album in 1984, especially for my parents as a gift that it gave me this beautiful culture and song. I've been thinking these days about America, Japan, Canada, Europe, just to do something for them. And somebody discovered this album in Israel, a DJ, English DJ that will work. He worked on a pirate radio station in Israel.
Oh.
So he sent it to his friends in London, and, you know, they loved it, and they bought the rights. So everything happens to me like a surprise. Like, I was so happy in Israel. I'm still happy in Israel, and I didn't think to go outside, but, you know, here I am.
I wanted to ask you particularly about that song, because that song was sampled by a lot of rap artists.
Right, right.
How do you feel about sampling?
It was a big surprise for me when I heard the first time about my voice in the rap song in America. But to tell you the truth, it gave a big push to my single.
Pump up the volume, pump up the volume.
That didn't know me wanted to know who is this voice, who is the person behind this voice, and I gave them a culture and really good history and very big history about the Yemenite Jews. People know me about from the Yemenite songs, traditional album, and when we did this conversion the first time, it was because of the children of my manager, you know, told us, please do something for us, and then we realized that they want also to hear this music.
Right.
And we said, it's great to bring these teenagers to my music.
Your audience is a big cross-section, I assume. All ages of people are into your music.
Yeah, and I'm very proud of